will be brewing come Sunday in Atlanta. The two opposing running backs will be a good one. Rams' Todd Gurley, Patriots' Sony Michel, both first-round picks, both from the University of Georgia, both will be heavily called upon within their offenses. And when asked about playing his former teammate, Gurley kept it simple and said, "I want to beat him." All right, Coach, which team has the better running game?
With that insight, I don't know where to go. Pretty good. I feel like I really know the plan now. This is a hard one.
Funny guy, Coach.
Thanks. I do what I can. The Rams have done such a good job through the course of the playoffs in terms of stopping the run. They had the incredibly effective day against Dallas running the ball, which nobody, I think, saw coming, especially not in that degree. Now that being said, one of the things I like about New England is their ability to move players where they want them to be, and the certainty of where Sue and where Donald will be versus Brockers and Fowler. So that, to me, will help New England. And I would imagine their approach is going to be run right at Donald and Sue. I would double-team those guys, be physical on the first level, and then get up on those little linebackers, because the linebackers are small. Those behind-the-line guys are small for your typical linebackers. And then if you want to run the ball outside, I would do that at Brockers and Fowler, because Fowler has a little bit more trouble setting the edge, and Brockers has a little more trouble moving laterally. So that, to me, is the approach I imagine they'll take. And then incorporating Cordarrelle Patterson in the running game, it may be some inside, some outside, but also the threat that he'll project on those misdirections where they don't give it to him and end up handing it off inside. I like that package of plays that New England has.
And just to build off that, I do wonder if the Rams will do more than Kansas City did in involving Brandon Cooks in their running game, when Kansas City never gave the ball to Tyreek Hill on a speed sweep, never just gave him the ball, get the ball in his hands behind the line of scrimmage, see if he can go make a play. I think the question's very interesting, because if the question were, who has the better running backs? That's an easy question. That's the Rams. They've got, in my eyes, the best running back.
Well, easy questions don't make the show.
Right. No, of course. But I want to just draw for the audience the distinction between, because I think you hear this, you say, well, maybe the team with Todd Gurley, offensive player of the year in the NFL, maybe the best running back in the league, but it's the running game. So it's to Coach's point, how you use those guys and how those guys match up against the opposition. Where New England has, with Trey Flowers and with the way they built that defensive line, been dedicated to finding big, strong guys that, to quote Coach, would rather punch than dance and will want to fight you in that phone booth. And the Rams, who, despite having what I consider to be a lot of talent on that defensive line throughout the regular season, were very bad stopping the run. Now, in the playoffs, it's been a different story. But in the regular season, they had been a bad run-stuffing team. So I think it is a little more nuanced than the talent of each backfield would suggest.
Yeah, it has nothing to do with talent. It's about scheme. New England's running attack is built for New England's going to put seven guys in the phone booth, and when you look at the tail of the tape, they will dwarf James Devlin and Rob Gronkowski. When you look at him matched up against the linebackers, Mark Barron is undersized. He was a strong safety at Alabama. Now he's playing inside linebacker for the Rams. He is not an inside linebacker. And Bill Belichick and Tom Brady will make sure that they take advantage of that. James Devlin blocking up on that second level. You double team Ndamukong Suh. You double team Aaron Donald. You have one other free lineman that's able to get up on that second level. So it's not about talent. It's not about Todd Gurley. It's not about CJ. No, it's not about them. It's about that blocking scheme. And I believe that the Rams have the best offensive line. They're the only team in the NFL offensive line starts every game this year. So I think they have a better offensive line. But when it comes down to scheme, and Coach had another little tidbit based on his Super Bowl experience, know it's going to be a neutral crowd. Coach knows they're going to go no huddle early. So they're going to be able to pick out where they are, New England. Where is Ndamukong Suh? Okay, well, we're either going to run at him or we're going to come up with some type of wham block to take advantage of his aggressiveness. So in a neutral site game like the Super Bowl, a lot of corporate fans, they don't have the noise impact on the game. It's the best time to go no huddle in any of the other playoff games, any other environment, because it's corporate and it's very quiet to a certain degree.
And it's about awareness as well. So oftentimes will motion a wide receiver in and help crack down on a defensive end. So he'll come from the outside in and block down. And some teams have, those defensive ends have no awareness. It's like they've seen the play for the first time, and New England takes advantage of that, those types of things. Or they'll get the defensive lineman to run up the field, thinking pass, and then they run a draw. Or now it's a trap, an inside trap, where the defensive lineman thinks, oh, God, I penetrated. What a great play I made. And then he gets ear-holed and blown up. So it's going to be about that for the Rams, too. And I think New England has excellent awareness in terms of what teams are trying to get done against them. It's how good of an awareness that defensive front will have of what New England's going to do to them.
And how much about the Patriots' predictability will they have to change up? And by predictability, I mean you use the numbers a lot over the last few weeks. When Devlin and Sony are on the field, they run the ball 85%+ of the time. When James White was on the field against the Chargers, they passed the ball 97% of the time. Mm-hmm. Those numbers are extremes, but it's similar to throughout the year. James White, if he's on the field, it's a pass play. He's either going to chip block or he's going to go out and to receive a pass. Sony Michel in there, it's a running play, certainly if James Devlin's out there. Do you think they stay consistent to that formula, or they switch it up in the Super Bowl with 2 weeks prepare so Wade Phillips has another thing to deal with?
I'm sure they have a plan, but even in the playoffs, because I gave everyone the script. No one listened to me. The Chargers, they didn't listen to me. Mm-hmm. I said, hey, man, when the meathead comes in, the fullback,
because
typically it's not James Devlin, but we call a fullback a meathead because he don't need a whole bunch of meat to make a meal. Yeah. He's looking for something to
or
hit.
Or dump truck is not.
Yeah, absolutely. And when he's on the field, those are numbers in the regular season. It's 91% him and Sony Michel on the field. So what they've done, I would force them to go out of it. If they bring James Devlin's on the field, Sony Michel, I'm going eight people in the box. I'm going to force you to make them do. Those are the things you have to make New England do and realize that they will change. They will put James White in the game in the second half. And you know what they're going to do?
Run
him on a draw. Yep. So, yes, it's the Super Bowl, and you're just going to have to be better because you're not going to be able to know when they're doing certain things. You're going to just have to be better and be able to beat guys and be able to get guys on the ground as far as tackling.
And here's the tough thing about tendencies is you'll go into the meeting room and you're like, look, fellas, it's 97% that they're going to run the ball. And then what you try to do offensively is break that tendency early. Now,
yes,
you only break it once, but then the guys come on the sideline and say,
they're like, oh, yeah,
I was playing
us
the run. You said it was going to be this. It's totally different this game. And remember, everybody assumes that New England's going to be different. They're going to have something special. So they only have to give you a little bit of cheese to make you believe it's something totally different.
Patriots tried to do that in last week's game in the first half. They tried to do that to throw them off their scent. But ultimately, it comes back. When James Devlin's in the game, I don't care if it's Rex Burkhead, I don't care who it is, they're going to run the football.
And you got to get the guys back over on the bench and say, look, they broke the tendency, but we're going to continue to play the odds here until they prove otherwise. So just hold your ground. It'll come back to who they are.
Coach, great insight as always. We'll see you a bit later in the show. Coming up, could Anthony Davis team up with Kevin Durant next season? That's next on First Things First.